For the debate, there is a moderator who is Toastmaster Vijay Ranjan. Basically, he is an entrepreneur and 5 years experience in Toastmasters. He has done MBA and MSc psychology. The debate topic is, there are two teams are available, team A and team B. The topic is lesson learned from COVID-19 enforcers. Topic for A team, to improve medical infrastructure. Topic for B team is to improve public awareness on health. When I asked Toastmaster Vijay Ranjan with a question, which one was made you to feel as renaissance or new beginning in your life? He has told, I have given two options. One is the moment he got married, and the second one is the moment he became as an entrepreneur. He has chosen the option two. He became as an entrepreneur. So in that way, he got a resonance in his life. Thank you, Toastmaster Vijay Rajan. Let me welcome to start the debate. Over to moderator.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Actually, when I'm afraid about Corona, we are discussing always about Corona, Corona, Corona. Today, you gave me an option whether you are happy with your wife or entrepreneur. So I got still more afraid. So anyway, so today we are going to have a wonderful debate session. We have three legends and three titans on the left and right. Left and right means you should not consider it as a political thing. Left side, you have people who are going to talk about medical infrastructure. The lesson that COVID-19 taught us is to enforce medical infrastructure. On the right side, you're going to have people who will talk about improving the public awareness on health. Actually, Corona, initially when Surgeon at Arms started the meeting, he said how Toastmasters have grown to so many countries, around 130, 140 countries over the period of 100 years. Corona has grown to more than 140, 150 countries in just 6 months, the power of Corona. Actually, Corona went to all the countries. It went to Corona reached Italy, Corona reached America. Everybody got tensed because of Corona. But only when it came to India, Corona got tensed. Because wherever you go, they are asking, what is the lesson you learned from Corona? What is the lesson you learned in lockdown? What is the skills that you developed in lockdown? What is the lesson you learned, the economists learned? What is the lesson social activists learned? Corona is asking. We have made Corona as a LKG teacher. So Corona got tensed when it came to India. In reality, my dear friends, jokes apart, actually in reality, this kind of disasters teach great lessons to humanity. They say that the word quarantine means 40 days. 600 years back, when foreigners used to come to a new country, they will quarantine the invaders, the new people from other country for 40 days. That became quarantine. That is where the word quarantine was derived. So this habit of making people to stay in the ship for 40 days existed some 600 or 700 years back, but we have forgotten that lesson. So in every disaster, we have a lesson to learn. That is what today's debate is all about. So without much delay, people are waiting for the titans and legends to give a speech. So for to start with, we have a speaker from Team A, that is to improve medical infrastructure, that is Hemant Krishna. He's a tax professional. Who else can know? Being a tax professional, he is the person who will know how the government gets taxes, extracts money from people, from the citizens. What are all the aspects and what are all the ways the tax can be collected? Only Hemant can know it better. So who has the authenticity and command to demand that we need a better medical infrastructure? So Without much delay, let me give the screen to Hemant Krishna on screen. Hemant?
Yes, hello to all the members. Good evening. And it's a beautiful Saturday to debate on the infrastructure, the COVID needs, the pandemic demands. By now, all of us should have become experts in few things. This pandemic has taught us how to wash our hands, definitely how to use the soaps and the hand washes for 20-25 seconds, which we never knew earlier, probably we never practiced. And the second thing is how to use hand sanitizers. And the third thing is to make and drink kashayams. And the fourth thing is to track the number of corona cases, news every time. And the last thing is trying to practice social distancing. As we do all this, the number of cases still are increasing. As we talk right now, Chennai would have recorded another 2,000 cases today. And definitely another proud reason to be, at Chennai 8 is that we always are in the top three, just like in IPL. So we have around 40,000 cases just in Tamil Nadu, of which 80% of the cases will just be from Chennai. So when I talk about infrastructure, I talk about the medical facilities, the medical care any layman is possibly getting during any times of sickness for a human being. So about that, irrespective of any country that we're talking about, either poor or developing or developed, we all should value the human life. Although the educational levels can vary with every individual, I will just very strongly tell you, and I believe in any government which is governing should have an equal importance to all the human life, irrespective of their economic status. So if I'm very aware and educated, and I will definitely do social distancing, but if you are going to create awareness to any fraction of the society and expect them to be self-aware and follow hygiene and not have great infrastructure when it comes to hospital beds, I am telling you that on a very small community it might work, but when you stand as a country without any great infrastructure, we definitely will fall down. One quote that I remember when I talk right now is, divided we stand, we fall, united we are, we stand strong. By that, what I mean, only when you have an infrastructure that's like the foundation of the healthcare, any person will unitedly stay strong, like in a nation. So my point here is, the awareness that is being created by all the cinema stars, I don't know when they became doctors, about all coming in advertisements and talking about health and, few videos that are being made on in the name of awareness gets me really angry. There was a song that was made and I was really angry, and I think all of you would have definitely come across that. That's like corona corona enna konnudada veena moochukulla neeyum varavena. Wait, where are you drawing the line between awareness and entertainment? Now, is this important? Or changing the name from Egmore to Elumbur is important? Or number of beds in a government hospital admitting the poor people is important? Now, all my focus is, why is the government, I don't want to get into the taboo topic of government, but having said that, it is very important when we talk about infrastructure. I, as a person, cannot make infrastructure anywhere. My contribution can be maybe practicing self-hygiene and creating awareness to my family within my friends. But you look at the larger picture about the statistics and everything, which my team member will follow with all the statistics. Infrastructure is where that should be the main reason. All the cases right now, luckily in India, we have good immune system. Yeah. And also that 50% of the cases in India are recovered. So that's also fine. But I am talking about the testing that is done. How about Chennai? They say the number of cases are more because the testing is two times, which means in Chennai, one day case is equal to any other state 2 days case count. Having said that, also, if I tell you that I directly have friends in Chennai who are doctors, and they tell me that the testing is not even the tip of the iceberg. So we are all sitting on top of the danger, and we don't know how deep we are going to fall and how badly it is going to hurt us. You know, having said that, economy is crumbling in India. So all of this to revive, it is definitely important to create effective awareness, keeping in mind the end goal is to not create awareness, but to revamp and revive effective infrastructure. Talk about medicinal infrastructure. Let the government cap the private companies, private hospitals, which are scams that you know and I know everybody in the world knows. When they say the government actually has to charge 3,800 rupees, they're charging few thousands, say 15,000. I can give you with the proof of all that. So when the government has to regulate, when they say N95 mask, they say N95 mask original. They shouldn't be like a printed N95 in a cotton cloth and be selling it. So I'm talking about infrastructure from the grassroots levels of a very micro thing to a patient being admitted and he's being treated with effective care and with utmost hygiene. Inside the government hospital, people do not go there because they think the infrastructure is so bad that they might not die of corona, but they will die of the infrastructure that is so bad. Now, let us talk about improving infrastructure on a real-time basis. That is, I'm not against awareness, but I think we all know that infrastructure is the way forward and awareness to an extent is just capped. Having said that, let us move on to the next speaker to listen to them. Thank you.
A great speech, Hebat. It's really an amazing speech, a fantastic beginning. This is a Sachin Tendulkar start. You have given a fantastic start for this debate. And they're very logical, and also you emoted it well. The next speaker we are going to have is a very veteran Toastmasters. He has been with Toastmasters for almost 14 years, and he's going to talk about how the lesson learned from COVID-19 is to enforce us to improve public awareness on health. Yes. 15 years experience on pharma selling. Who else can have the authenticity to talk on awareness in awareness and health? So let me welcome Toastmaster Pat on stage. Let me share the screen with Toastmaster Pat. Toastmaster Pat.
Pat, sir, you got to unmute.
Yes, I believe I am audible.
Yes, you are audible.
Mr. Moderator, my dear rivals and fellow Toastmasters, permit me at the outset to make a humble request to all of you, including my rival team members. This I am saying purely in the interest of your health, well-being, renaissance, and reintegration. Never ever allow yourself to undergo the medical treatment of corona infection. It is not that easy procedure. If you refuse to hear my words or our words, my other two team members' words, then you can join the other team. February 14, Valentine celebration. March 14, quarantine. Prevention is always better than cure. Prevention is possible by consciously being aware of the doables. That is very important. The doables against the corona infection. Let us take the success story of Taiwan, a close neighbor of China, similar to New Zealand, that reports zero case of corona just because of high intensity of public awareness measures. Could they have treated all the patients in a matter of, say, 60 days, ever since corona emerged? It is by means of these preventive measures they have avoided the possibility of infection or corona contraction. So in Taiwan, it was possible. Both the government's preventive public awareness schemes and its citizens' implementation support to bring corona infection to nil. today why Chennai's infection rate is alarmingly ascending. Our debater said that 2,000 cases today. It is because of the foolish move the government did on April 25th. How many asymptomatic carriers would have mingled with many unsuspecting people? Ladies and gentlemen, what happened 2 days ago when TTD, the Tirupati Devasthanam, announced distribution of laddu, Kanna Laddu Thanasaya, on Venkat Narayana Road? How people madly gathered and mobbed to receive the laddu, totally unmindful of consequences. Remember, majority of them are educated idiots. Therefore, it is not just awareness program, it is going to be a conscious and religious awareness programs. Who can save us if this is the mindset? Therefore, the government should not be frightening, but masterminding the attitude of the people. Mark my words, there is no self-isolation insistence now. People can come out. There is no external surveillance. Only our self-control and self-discipline are very important. Okay, I'm giving an example. Newly wedded couple. Say for the first month, whatever wife says, husband listen. And whatever husband says, wife listen. Public awareness should be strong enough to force people to listen and follow the doables. You heard of that Colgate advertisement? Upinyanam, upinyanam, upinyanam. The dance sort of over on the part. And the mari sam corona jnanam, corona jnanam, corona jnanam, to be shown frequently in all the TV channels. Social activists, volunteers can come forward to generate awareness through skits, spoofs. Repetition is the art of communication. Though it's a cliche, SMS has to be continued. That is, sanitization, masking the face, social distancing. And film stars, yes, we go after them to promote the danger of roaming outside meaninglessly without protection that can be highlighted by them very strongly. It is safe to distance 6 feet. If we consciously maintain this, we can delay our eventual 6 feet. Man, mark my words. Present 6 feet distance can help us delay our eventual 6 feet. It is only a strong caution. It is not to scare the public. Public should know the dire consequences of death. Life is not so cheap to lose it so swiftly. Therefore, show the dead body of the corona affected even after medical treatment. If possible, get some feedback from the courageous relative to pose a question to the public, who is responsible for this life loss. Now it's about prevention from our end. Build a filter around us psychologically and physiologically. The psychological filter is to infuse mind with the thoughts of hope, peace, courage, confidence, so on. The physiological fit is to build our or enhance our inherent immunity by means of food intake, regular physical exercise, association with positive people. Positive thoughts. So if you can afford to do that, please decide which is better, undergoing medical treatment by way of increased infrastructure or preventing the possibility of attack of corona, because prevention is always better than cure. I will come back to you again. Back to the moderator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pat. It was an enriching speech. And I wanted to give one information for the audience. In today's debate session, at the end of the debate, you have an opportunity to raise a question, couple of questions to our debaters, and they will answer. Or else you can validate certain speeches. So be just a word so that you can take notes. If you want to take notes or something, you can do that. And so we had a fantastic speech which had a strong evidence. Toastmaster Pat spoke with a lot of strong evidences. But the next speaker, the lawyer, Madhupriya, who can argue without evidences. So whether these evidences provided by Toastmaster Pat will stand before the lawyer, let us check. Toastmaster Madhupriya.
Can you all hear me?
Yes, we hear.
Yes, my voice. Thank you. Very good evening, moderator, my rebel team, and fellow Toastmasters. First of all, I would like to make a point very clear to Toastmaster Pat, my rival team captain. Toastmaster Pat, the population of Taiwan is just 2.38 crores. Population of India is 1.35 crores. You say that handling 2.38 crores and handling 135 crores is the same? Just by creating awareness, is it possible to do so? 2 days back, I saw a person painting on the road. I asked him, what is that? And he said, he's painting coronavirus on the roads. I saw an auto with all those strips. And he's saying, auto is a depiction of coronavirus. He has 5% for 1,000. Just compare the ratio. The ratio is really shocking. And there are only 25,000 ventilators. Critical care units and ventilator support. This is very important because corona has something to do with our lungs, breathing problem. So we have just 25,000 ventilators. What is the total number of people who have been affected by corona in India? Goes to lakhs. Just compare the ratio. Where are we going? Yes, as Pat told, it's important to go for jogging. It's important to go for running. Eating good foods, taking vitamin C, but we have been doing this for years and years. And why the toll has been so great? That's a point right now. There is something which has been really impossible for the government authorities to not practically implement. That is the reason now India has crossed nearly 13 lakhs, Tamil Nadu 40,000. The rate is really shocking. The medical professionals, doctors and nurses, they don't have proper PPEs, personal protective equipment. What's the point in talking about eating amla, drinking golden milk? Yes, I do accept. It's very important. And we have been doing that. But in spite of that, in a community spreading, in a pandemic, just drinking golden milk or eating amla, that is not enough. I just want to make one point clear. Beds, isolation wards, medical facilities, the government has been implementing more and more on it, but it is not enough because already we have lost a lot of points, decades and decades of neglect. Now it's very difficult for them to cope up with this situation. Washing hands, I see many actors coming telling us how to wash our hands, using sanitizers, drawing coronavirus on roads, masks, everything. Just imagine there is a beggar. You go and ask him. Like, you know, see, now the corona is fast spreading and you're supposed to wear a mask. Go buy a mask for rupees 10. Will he go and buy a mask? No. If that 10 rupees was in his hands, I'm 100% sure he'll go and buy some biscuits or food for him to eat. This is the situation of India. We are not economically stable. In such a country, is it not possible to create awareness that will not serve us because people are not in a position to undergo, to wear a mask or to buy a 60 rupees, 70 rupees sanitizer and use it all over their hands. Now it is not possible because we are a developing country. How can you expect a poor lady who has two children to go and buy a sanitizer for rupees 60 when she's starving for food? So, in an economic unstable situation, what is important is the government should focus on medical facilities. Either you make the country economically stable, like you give food to everybody, make food available, the basic need for every human being, that is the food. When you don't have food, how are you expecting people to go wear a mask and, you know, stay home, stay safe? My fruit seller, I meet her every day. She told me openly, either I will die out of hunger or I will die out of corona. Anyway, I'm going to die. Let not be of hunger. So she came out and she is selling fruits now. So what's the point in me going telling her, you eat amla, you go for jogging, you go for running. Now what's the point in telling that? Government has been taking so many measures to create awareness. I'm seeing Kamala Hassan, I'm seeing Gautami. I'm seeing all superstars, Amala Pal, telling us how to wash hands, what soap to be used, what type of masks to be on, all those things. Even an auto rickshaw wala is able to clearly tell what are the safety measures or precautions he or she is supposed to take during this corona. But what is the use? My point is, what is the use? Everything has turned out to be futile. The rate is alarming. being a banker, I'm supposed to go for bank, I'm working, but I'm feeling so insecure. This is the situation here. There is a person coming from Trivikanagar, there's a person coming from Vyasarpadi, Kodambakam. You know, it's a mixture of people coming from various areas. So what's the point? Security here. I'm washing my hands, yes. Nearly 20 times I'm washing my hands, I'm using sanitizer. But still, there are possibilities, there is possibility. And that's the reason the toll has been increasing in a rapid speed. Our government so far is spending only 1.3% of our GDP to healthcare. I don't know how many of you know this. Only just 1.3% of the GDP to healthcare. Now they themselves are planning to increase this percentage. When government themselves are so sure that only medical facilities, improvement of medical infrastructures can solve this issue. We have to understand, right? Medical awareness. Is it fine? But not at this stage. I think தலைக்கு மேல வெள்ளம் போனதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஜான் என்ன மொடம் என்ன அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. Now the situation has crossed the limits. Now there's no point in going and telling, yes, as my team had told her, Toastmaster Hemant, there is one song, Corona, Corona. What is the point in that? I was watching that and laughing. At one time I felt really very angry. But at the same time, what's the use in that? They are making people to dance for it. What's the use? Spending so much in decorating their helmets, spending so much in decorating the roads. But what should be done so far is not done. I won't say it's not done, it's being done partially. So now I am just emphasizing that government authorities should focus more on medical infrastructures, because in a developing country like India, only that will be a permanent measure. Everything else is ad hoc. Washing hands, doing all those fancy things, everything is ad hoc measures. I would like to ask a question to Toastmaster Pat or my revival team. Toastmaster Pat, I'm planning to send you to an corona ward. I'm going to do a sanitizer with gloves, with mask. You can really go there wearing all these mask, gloves, sanitizer. Have you got that guts to go there? I'm asking you, with all these precautions, all these awareness. No, nobody will do that, because awareness is entirely different. We have to speak reality. So in this case, I would like to add one point which Pat has told. He asked a question, is life so cheap? Yes, I'm asking you that. Is life so cheap? Just by following these advertisements and awareness, you're putting us into risk. So you don't want medical facilities when you're not affected by cold or cough or doctor. I think Pat will not go to any hospital or he'll not consult any doctor. So my dear members, I just want to put this point very straight to you all. National security is the imperative. It is the basic thing, as food, shelter, clothing. I think medical facility is a very basic demand for every citizen of India. We have lost it, I understand now, but again, we have to rebuild it. And this is the situation, the best lesson that Corona COVID-19 has taught us. Improve your medical infrastructure. After agriculture, the second thing that the government should give importance is improve medical infrastructure. With that point, I'm just leaving it to the team B for the next speaker. Thanks a lot for this opportunity.
Thank you, Mother Priya. Did I not tell you? Evidences will not stand before lawyer. A kili-kili speech by Mother Priya. But the next speaker, she's not a lawyer, but she is a don of Tamil Nadu Toastmasters. I have seen her speeches, but her speeches will withstand a lawyer's speech. She has been with Toastmasters for 3 years. And she says, when I asked about herself, she says that she is interested in Indian culture and tradition. Maybe a corona effect, Indian culture and tradition. So let me give the screen to Toastmaster Kundavi on stage. Toastmaster Kundavi.
Good evening, all. I'm really happy and privileged to talk in this wonderful topic. As I said, as I was introduced, I'm very much into Indian culture and our traditional habits. So I strongly believe that prevention is better than cure. So let's come back to infrastructure later. What has Corona gave us? What kind of lessons you have learned from? What will you say? I have learned to wash my hands better. I have learned the importance of social distancing, which was already existing in my country. And I now know very well the importance of general cleanliness. And most of the people, not only Indians, even the World Health Organization once said, a month ago, that it is time for us to go back to our traditional values, traditional lifestyle, and traditional medicine. And in all this, India is in progress before us. This is the statement by World Health Organization. If they think that it is important for us to make an infrastructure, why would they request the whole world like that? If it is possible, they would have suggested, but the practical possibility is awareness, not infrastructure. I'm telling you why. See, 150 years ago, we people got electricity, okay? And at that time, many people died because they didn't know it will shock, electrocute you. But today, we have got the infrastructure. All our electricity poles are properly covered and we are not get electrocuted. But what we carry with us for the 150 years is, we people know the electricity will electrocute in certain circumstances. We are not depending on the infrastructure. We all carry that awareness. Only that awareness is saving us from so many accidents today. Not exactly that infrastructure, even if it fails. And I'm coming to one more point. In the past, that is about 100 years ago, there were cholera and many other diseases. Corona is not the first one which is invading us. We had many diseases. What we did, later on, we developed some medicine and some infrastructure, and the vaccinations are all taken over by the entire governments. All the governments made it a program. And when they started giving it, people didn't accept it initially. You would have heard that whenever a health person come into a village, people will run, hey, usi potra. They will run away. They wouldn't take it. But later, they understood it. But today, what we have achieved, we people are going on our own. As soon as a child is born, until the age of 12, we are giving vaccination at any point of time. We approach hospitals. We ensure that our children are having good health. This is the awareness created by the cholera that came 100 years ago. And this is what is going to save any community, any country, or any society. This awareness we have to carry forward. And corona is a kind of a peculiar disease because we haven't faced it already. Had we done that, we would have developed the infrastructure first. So my point is this, infrastructure comes, but it is not the beginning. After we get all the education, we have done all the testing, and we have found the solution, we make all these in order and we come up with the required infrastructure. But in our case, India is having a wonderful infrastructure. It is better than any other country in the world, I would say. I can say many evidences, but this is not the time for all that. With our existing infrastructure, we are fighting with corona now. Within the short duration of time, we have already built many infrastructure. But my query here is, that is not going to save people when such a pandemic, unforeseen crisis comes and attacks you. It is your traditional awareness you create among the people that is going to help you. I'm not going to give you any statistics. I'm going to show you only two things. One is the country, New Zealand. The other is the state, Kerala, very nearby state, Kerala. Have they have all the infrastructure? Are they worrying about the infrastructure which should be equivalent to the population of their country or state? No, they are not doing it. They are concentrating only on the awareness of people, and the people are supporting wholeheartedly their government. Why they are not having the important top 10 places just like people us, like us? Why Kerala is not competing with us in corona? Because of the awareness. See, it takes you a lot of time and effort and money and energy, everything to build infrastructure. Now we have seen what is the corona. We have analyzed in all possible ways. We have to build an infrastructure which is sufficient, which is capable of fighting this corona. We will need time. But when we don't have that time, we can pass a word, because the word can pass just like that. That is why Kerala won. That is why New Zealand won. And we people, we are a mixture. Our India is always a mixture. We are not kind of unique people. We are not always listening to what is coming from there. See, this awareness was successful in the first 1 month, but it is not now, because people think it is quite okay. See, there are no beds available for people now, because they are all filling up. And the amount charged by private hospitals, as our Madhu madam said, they are the person will die, instead of going to the hospital, they will die with corona. That is easy for them. I agree with that. Are we supposed to build beds which is equivalent to the population of a country? If we do so, who will be working on? She said, how life is cheap for you. No, it is not cheap. I actually respect the lives of doctors much, much more. That is why I say, let us not all get corona and go there and put their doctors' lives in crisis. We have to respect them. See, which is easier? Everybody getting corona, go there and asking for infrastructure, and everybody get the awareness, have it, and use our sense and save our people. By not having corona itself, we are saving people who are dying and serving us, which is easier, which should be taken. And if at all people are not taking this kind of learning, we have to spread only that word. We are not supposed to fight with the government or with the doctors or with anybody else. And one more thing, talikku mele vellam pona enna pandrathu? Talikku mele vellam pogum munnadiye புத்திசாலித்தனமா இருந்து கால் கிட்ட வரும் பொழுதே எஸ்கேப் ஆயிடும். தட் இஸ் வாட் வி ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டு. அண்ட் டு சம்மரைஸ் மை ஆர்குமெண்ட்ஸ், ஐ வில் சே இட் இஸ் மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஃபார் அஸ் டு பில்ட் இன்ஃப்ராஸ்ட்ரக்சர். வென் யூ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் த டைம், வென் யூ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் த ஆக்சுவல் ஐடியா, ஈவன் நவ் வி ஆர் நாட் அவேர் ஆஃப் வாட் த கொரோனா இஸ் கோயிங் டு டூ நவ், ரைட்? It is changing its shape at least 15 times now. It is the first corona, its child, and it is child, and it's just like we people have our child, grandchild, and the resemblance will be coming after 3 generations. That is how it is making its shape. So unless we find the solution, we cannot expect our government or anybody to have the appropriate infrastructure. What we have to do, we have to keep the one important infrastructure which is having in our brain. We have to improve it. We have to take all the learning. We have to help other people to win over it. Only awareness will help people, not only in this corona time, in over the years to come, centuries to come, as long as mankind lives. And with that, I'm handing over the session back to the moderator. Thank you.
Sabash, Sariyanam Putti. Actually, in Tamil, they used to say, Kairilpu poti, that is, there will be a big thread, and three people will be pulling this side and three people will be pulling that side. Then Madhu, the lawyer, spoke. Actually, the thread came this side. And right now, after Kundavi's speech, the thread again came to the team. The success of Kundavi's speech is, you know, she gave the success which we have already tasted. She spoke about the cholera, polio, in which we have already won. So she have all shared all the success stories and reinforced the confidence. So Team A shared all the tears, and Toastmaster Kundavi shared all the success stories, which has established stories. And now, right now, the thread is in Team A. So, but this person is a social activist. And he's from Satta Panchayat. Today, it is going to be a Katta Panchayat. Toastmaster Yuvaraj, actually, he's a YouTube blogger. So I'm very curious to hear from the Satta Panchayat secretary, joint secretary, Yuvaraj. please on stage.
Thank you, Vijay. Thanks everyone for the opportunity. Good evening, everyone. So we all agree that both awareness and infrastructure are important. Both teams, I'm sure, we both agree to that. But the point of contention between two teams is which is more important. That's the point of contention, and the whole debate is around that. Okay, let's say I'm following all the precautionary measures. I wear a mask when I go out, I use hand sanitizer, gloves, everything. But beyond that, if I am affected with COVID-19, do I have a bed in the hospital right now in Chennai? We don't have. Leave a common public like us. Doesn't doctors have enough awareness? Doctors are the one who prescribe what to do. What are the precautionary steps? What should we do? That's prescribed by the doctors. Today, we have hundreds of doctors affected by COVID-19. It's because there is no proper infrastructure at the hospital. As Madhu told, there is no proper PPE equipments right now at the hospitals. So doctors do have all the awareness. We don't have to teach them. They teach us. But still, they are affected because of lack of infrastructure. Let me give you some example. Say, if I'm a person, say I'm traveling in a train. I eat a packet of biscuit. I have a plastic cover with me. I know that I should put it in the dustbin. But if I don't have a dustbin in my coach, what would I do? A normal person would throw it in the coach itself, or someone maybe keep it in the bag, right? But see, again, when I have awareness and there is no proper infrastructure, in this case, it's a bin, it's a dustbin. When there is no proper infrastructure, then that's where the garbage piles up. This is one example that I want to give. And Madhu talked about a lot of numbers, including the beds, the capacity of beds and all. I have a little more numbers to give. World Health Organization recommends that there should be one doctor for a population of 1,000 people. Whereas in India, there is one doctor for a population of 1,500 people. So the actual requirement in India for a population of close to 130-135 crore is we need 13 lakh doctors. This is not for COVID-19. This is on a general day, even before pandemic, even after the pandemic, on a general day, on a normal day, not to treat the COVID-19. I'm talking about a normal day. We need 13 lakh doctors. But what we have only 9 lakh doctors. We have countries like Italy, Germany, Spain, US. They all have great infrastructure, but still they are facing the crisis. It's because COVID-19 is something unprecedented and none of us have expected. But I'm talking about on a normal day. On a normal day, countries like Italy, Spain, US, they all have good infrastructure. But in India, even on a normal day, we don't have a proper infrastructure. Let's talk about a few more data. World Health Organization recommends that there should be one nurse for a population of 330 people. Whereas in India, we have one nurse for a population of 675. That is where the requirement is 40 lakh nurses, whereas the availability is just 20 lakhs. Again, bed capacity, Madhu Priya told that there should be 5 beds for a population of 1,000. Let's take Chennai for example. Chennai and its suburban areas with a population of almost 1 crore requires at least 50,000 beds, Chennai and its suburban areas, as per the WHO recommendation. That's on a normal day, not even for COVID-19. But even a few days back, we have our Secretary Pila Rajesh giving a statement that in government hospitals, we have only 5,000 beds. We need 50,000 beds. In government hospitals, we have 5,000 beds. And again, in private hospitals, there are few more thousand, which put together like, comes around 10 to 12,000. We are like 80% shortage of our requirement. That's the state of infrastructure, health infrastructure in India. And a lot of people talked about Kerala, Taiwan, and other successful countries like South Korea, New Zealand. Let me give you some numbers for these places where they have successfully controlled COVID-19. Taiwan, they spend almost 2 lakh rupees per person just for healthcare per year. Per person, that's per capita expenditure. That's called as per capita expenditure. Taiwan spends almost 2 lakh rupees South Korea, which is almost equal in size of Tamil Nadu's population, they spend almost, again, 2 lakh rupees, which is 8% of their GDP. New Zealand, which even though its population is less, let's compare the per capita expenditure, head-to-head expenditure. That's what would be a proper comparison. Per capita expenditure in New Zealand is 3 lakh rupees. That's 9% of their GDP. Let's come to India. We spend just 2,000 rupees per capita for healthcare. Just 2,000 rupees per person per year for healthcare. This is just 4% of our GDP. Now, Kundavi gave an example about Kerala. Just let's compare the Indian states. Among the per capita expenditure within the Indian states, Kerala tops the list. They spend about 8,000 rupees per capita for health. Whereas its neighboring state, Tamil Nadu, we spend around 3,000 rupees per capita, which is not even half of what Kerala spends. So all this expenditure translates to infrastructure. Only if we have a proper budget allocation, we can improve the infrastructure. Even many of the government bodies, Niti Aayog, previously the Planning Commission, many expert committees, they all have recommended that India's health expenditure in GDP should go up to like 5 to 7% of GDP. Even the 4% of GDP that I mentioned, only 1.6% is spent by the government. Remaining the 2.4% is our out-of-pocket spending, that the amount we spend on private hospitals. Again, to talk about the doctors again, I told we have one doctor for a population of 1,500. That's again put together government and private doctors. When we take only the government doctors, we have one doctor for a population of 11,000, which is like 1/10 of what is required. This is where India stands in terms of infrastructure. So to give another example of South Korea, South Korea spends about 12 lakh rupees, because South Korea and Tamil Nadu have same population. I want to give this as well. South Korea spends about 12 lakh rupees for healthcare. Tamil Nadu's budget, which was passed a few months back, the amount allocated for healthcare is just 12,000 rupees, which is just just 1% of what South Korea spends. So we all talk about South Korea, Kerala, Taiwan, New Zealand. They have successfully controlled COVID-19 because of awareness. But we don't look at the other side of the picture. The other side is infrastructure, actually. As I already told, who has the greatest level of awareness, and still they are getting affected by COVID-19. A lot of doctors and medical students, medical professionals. We all tell we need to have, as a awareness, as a precautionary measure, we should have gloves, mask, PPE, and everything, right? If we have awareness, we all should have that. But even the supply of those things are not enough. That's again infrastructure. We don't have enough medical colleges, enough seats in medical colleges to produce the amount of doctors and nurses and other medical professionals that are actually required. So that's where we are lacking a lot. And I'm sure this COVID-19 will be this pandemic should be turned into an opportunity to improve our health infrastructure. And I hope things will turn positive from COVID positive to healthcare positive, I hope. So with this, I conclude my statement and hand it over back to Vijay.
Thank you, Yuvraj. An allied activist for the first 3 minutes, full of statistics, bombarded with statistics. It's almost like Vijay Gandhi giving statistics continuously for 3 minutes. So many evidence, so many statistics to prove the point. Right now, the next person, actually, I was waiting for this person. He is a media person, television journalist. We are waiting for you there. More than Corona, they are showing some kind of this kind of image, and they are creating some kind of a panic. Now, that creates more death than this COVID-19, I personally feel. So Siddharth is a television journalist. He's a reporter for Vyan for 2 years, and he deals with a plethora of subjects. He is going to be the third speaker from Team B. I think he will share still more points for their team. The Toastmaster Siddharth on stage.
So my respected opponents, all of them, in fact, had started by saying that we need infrastructure, we need infrastructure, we need more spending on GDP. Here are some more numbers to counter what you had perhaps said earlier. America surely spends about 15% of their GDP, and their GDP is around about $20 trillion. And our GDP is around about $2 to $3 trillion. We spend 1.28% to 1.3% of our GDP. Despite having all this GDP and all the major pharma companies in the world and the research institutions in the world, why is it that America has the maximum number of COVID cases and also the maximum number of COVID deaths across the world? Is this what infrastructure does? Is this the gain that you have from the maximum infrastructure in the world? There was a photo in the New York Times, it was a cover photo, where they had no space in their conventional Christian burial grounds to bury the dead. So they had to dig up places in different parts of America where empty lands were there. And they had to line up coffins one by one. And nobody knew whose body was in which coffin, because nobody was allowed there anyways. So they had to dump bodies en masse. So this is the state of a country that spends about 15% of their GDP. That is 15% of $20 trillion plus on their infrastructure. So if it's just about infrastructure, then why is it that different countries have different ways of dealing with this pandemic? Let me just take two examples. And I would like to state that it's awareness and also obedience that actually contributes in this fight against this pandemic. Let me take the example of Japan. You might say Japan's population is so small that India is a subcontinent and Japan is the size of a supermarket. Okay, Japan is the size of a supermarket. I understand. But do we also acknowledge the fact that Japan has the maximum population density in the world in Tokyo? And Japan also has the maximum aging population in the world. But why is it that most Japanese people live over 100 years of age? It's because they don't have what we call comorbidities. They don't have diabetes. They don't have cholesterol. They don't have heart problems. They don't have hypertension. They don't have any of these that are common names in Indian households. Well, and this is the case also in many of the Western countries. Most of our people have comorbidities a dime a dozen. So you can go ask somebody, what is your medical history? He will say, I got this from my father. I got this from my mother. So is this some sort of family property that somebody inherited and somebody gave it to you? So this is ridiculous. So we are demanding infrastructure. But how fit are we as a people? Most of us know that there is something called as walking and running only after the lockdown. Most people are wondering about gym memberships only after the lockdown, after the gyms closed. How healthy are we as a population? Besides this, let me also draw your attention to how reckless rascals we are as a people. I almost step out every day to report, and I've seen that completely sensible, educated people violate the laws quite blatantly. And you've seen this too. Most people know that corona affects the throat and later the lungs. Our people are such geniuses that they wear not at the inlets where the coronavirus perhaps can enter your throat and your lungs. Most of them wear the mask at the neck. Is this the awareness that we have? Is this the sort of awareness that we have? Many people question, why do you have auto rickshaws and why do you have people having corona helmets? The reason is simple, because our population is not educated. You've got to bloody put the fear of death in their heads, and only then will they understand what corona is. In global countries, say in Dubai, in big countries, say in Australia, you have this example where they light up the Burj Khalifa or they light up the Opera House or perhaps Times Square and say, you know, stay careful against corona. We don't have any of that. We can't light up the Taj Mahal because Taj Mahal already is actually somebody's grave. So you can't create awareness on a grave. So my point is that you need an obedient population at first. Yesterday, I'm not sure if many of my opponents know this, the corporation filed cases against 40 people because they were COVID positive and they were in Chennai and they were roaming outside despite being COVID positive. They violated lockdown rules. About 12 crores have been collected in fines from people in Tamil Nadu alone for violating the lockdown. Perhaps this could be even Chennai. I just have to recheck that figure. But here's how I would like to conclude. Sometimes it's just not awareness, but also an obedient population. Both Japan and Israel, very small countries, but yet Japan has a very vulnerable population. But we know in Japan's case, and in Israel's case, their population is obedient. In America, we had all our white American friends protesting when this was happening. Americans were saying, we have the right to go out. Who is this guy Trump to impose a lockdown? They are saying that we are not in communist China. If you want a lockdown, go to China for the lockdown. Well, when you have people like this in democracies like ours, it is pretty natural that you will have COVID infections surging. Finally, with regards to infrastructure, I reported in April, and I can share the link in the chat bar, where after seeing so many dead bodies being dumped out in the open in Italy and people dying of COVID without ventilators in the roads, Indian Railways started converting their second class coaches into isolation wards, and several thousand of them have been converted. And when the need for beds arise, these coaches can be moved across the country and people can use them as isolation beds. Thus, I rest my case. Thank you.
Thank you, Siddharth. That's the power of a journalist. It was indeed a fantastic speech. I think we are running out of time. So without much delay, let us go to the rebutting phase. Now, this time, from Team B, there's our position leader, Toastmaster, but will be rebutting the his point of view. Toastmaster, but.
Okay. Madhupriya said Taiwan is a small country. Yeah, I do understand 135 crores is huge, but divided amongst the 38 to 48 states. Okay, why the rate of infection is less in India, though the population is very huge as compared to other countries, it is because of the basis we have, the traditional and conventional food system which we have been following. So our awareness system is not just SMS alone, that is sanitizing, mask and washing hands. It's also about building inherence within us. Madhu is asking me whether I have the guts to go out. Lawyers may be liars. And lawyers ramble inside the court. Therefore, lawyers may hesitate to go out. I am a trainer. I mingle with people. In every class of mine, I have 60 students. Therefore, I am throwing a challenge to Madhupriya. Monday morning, I am ready. Do you have the guts to accompany me to Rayabrum? I will get the answer later. Right. Varadarajan, the news reader, I think a few days ago, clearly stated that one of his close relatives got infected. Private hospitals, government hospitals, nowhere a space could be got. And finally, the patient died. Do you think it is, yes, it is important to develop infrastructure. Is it so easily possible to build so much infrastructure compared to the huge population we have? Therefore, prevention comes better because Yura said, it's a question of which is more important. Therefore, it becomes more important for the public awareness mechanism. Right. If awareness increases, we can avoid hospitalization. Another thing, Madhupriya said, thalaikku mela vellam ponal. Sari, thalaikku mela vellam poyachi. At least this prevention mechanism can help the non-infected to build a platform to rise above the vellam so that they can become safer. Okay, awareness is not only the SMS. It is change in our lifestyle. It is more important. What is that lifestyle? I will show you finally one slide so that you can read and appreciate it. It is about, I think they say that, I think which I do. Morning, warm water, bit of turmeric, honey, lemon, pepper, and drink it twice a day. It may not help you prevent corona, but it can build your inherent resistance, immunity to prevent corona. And Madhupriya also said, auto, car, helmet, all those gimmicks we need. I think as our last speaker, journalist rightly put it, I think we have laymen in our country who move outside. They cannot learn anything. If I go and talk, they may not. Whereas if some Trisha or someone comes and says, at least he will look at it. He will pay some attention. Therefore, they are not that educated. Therefore, we need that kind of powerful awareness program. All right, dustbin. I think he said dustbin in train. You go and throw it. Okay, there is. In Singapore, when you visit, if you feel like spitting, bloody hell, you can't. So you have your coat pocket and you spit it into the coat pocket. When you come to Mylapore, you spit it outside. Man, who prevented you in Singapore? Who gives you the right and authority to spit? It is a question of self-discipline. I think our man, the journalist rightly put it, it is about awareness and obedience. That obedience which I call self-discipline. So that self-discipline, which I call it, can help us to prevent. That prevention is better than cure. GDP, statistics and all that, okay, too much. My mentor used to say, too much of statistics will lead to paralysis. So we are not for paralysis. We are for prevention of paralysis. Therefore, we need to multidimensionally attack this public awareness program. I want to show one slide. I think, Mike, can you help me share the screen if you can give me the right or enable me, I can show it.
You can share, Pat, you can share it.
Okay, all right. You're able to see, or it should be magnified. The Jnana Kiravi, Avvai, Ellame Namakku Nalladha Thaan Bodhichirukka Avva. Avvaiyoda Vaarthaigale Namakku Prevention Thaan, Treatment Kadaiyaadhu. Hospital Poi, go to the hospital and face death. Rather than, protect yourself and prevent infection and therefore avoid death. The Corona Attitude, Adikkadi Kai Kaluvu. Then ஆபத்தை அறிந்து கொள் இல்லத்தில் தனித்திரு வீட்டில் இரு அங்கேயும் ப்ரிவென்ஷன் இஸ் நோ ஃபார் பெட்டர் ஈரடி தள்ளி நில் உற்றாரை ஒதுக்கி வை ஊரடங்கை மதித்து நட எங்கேயும் சுற்றாதே கண்டுபடி சுற்றாதே வேலை இஃப் இட் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் கோ அவுட் வித் ப்ரொடெக்ஷன் ஏக்கத்தை அடக்கி வை எப்பமா நம்ம வெளில போவோம் அப்படின்ற ஒருத்தி எஸ் அதுக்கும் காலம் வரும் ஐயமின்றி அனைத்தும் உண் அனைத்தும் உண்றது ஐ எம் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் தி அதுக்கு பேரு மிக்ஸ்டு ஃபுட் வாங்க இங்கிலீஷ்ல தமிழ்ல வந்து கலப்புணவு விச் இஸ் நதிங் பட் அவர் சால்ட் ஸ்வீட் சோர் அஸ்டிஞ்சன் ஹாட் பிட்டர் ஆல் பிட்டர் ஷுட் பி தேர் ஆல் ஷுட் பி தேர் தேன் தட் பில்ஸ் அவர் தட் இஸ் வாட் அவர் ஏன்ஷியன்ட் நோ ஃபுட் சிஸ்டம் அண்ட் ஃபுட் வேல்யூ தேன் எங்கேயும் சொல்ற இயக்கத்தை அடைக்கவே ஐயமின்றி அனைத்தும் உண் ஒதுங்கி இருக்க கற்றுக்கொள் ஓரிடத்தில் ஓய்ந்துரு அவுடுதம் அவுடுதம் மீன்ஸ் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் கொரோனாவிற்கு ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் கிடையாது என்னதான் இன்ஃப்ராஸ்ட்ரக்சர் எல்லாம் பண்ணாலும் ஓகே தே கேன் ஐதர் ஃபேஸ் டெத் ஆர் வி கேன் கம் பேக் இஃது அறிதலே இனிய வாழ்வு ஞானக்கிழவி கொடுத்த இந்த ஆத்திச்சூடியை இஃப் யூ கேன் ஃபாலோ அப்சர்வ் கான்சியஸ்லி அண்ட் ரிலீஜியஸ்லி வி கேன் டெஃபினெட்லி protect ourselves and prevent corona, then there is a possibility of medical or hospitalization will never occur at all. Let them keep attempting. Let them keep attempting to expand. That is also required. But at the same time, the significance or importance goes to the prevention by means of public awareness, special public awareness, rather than undergoing treatment. Back to the moderator.
Toastmaster Pat is not just the Toastmaster, he is also a member of Hypnatic. So it was a hypnatic speech in fact. So without much delay, let us go to the last speaker, Hemant Krishna, to talk in favor of medical topic. Hemant Krishna.
Well, Team B could try, but I just realized Team B either wants to talk about not catching the infection or wants to talk about malignant disease. So they do not have a bridge between catching the infection or being dead. What I'm saying is we have a filter that is infrastructure. People who are infected has to go back to the normal lives and not die. So very logically and very clearly, let me explain you a sequence of events very clearly. Well, see, none of us want to get infected, first place. And none of us want an accident, for example. So, say for Pat sir is a very aware person and he's a very rules-abiding person. He goes on a scooter. No, let's not take Pat sir, any person for that matter. And obviously, we drive all safe. Are you telling me that there is no accident possible ever? No. There are chances that you might be hit by a drunk person. He is not abiding rules. Obviously, in a population like in India, you cannot expect all of us to be 100% aware and follow the rules. Violators will be there. So no matter how the awareness is to you, you might still end up having the infection. Now, when you have the infection, obviously, what do? You cannot sit at home. So you are very clear that, see, you are very aware and you are very God-fearing, rules-abiding, you are going by the government and everything, but you know that you have to go to the hospital, meet the doctor. When I say go meet the doctor for an infection, which is contagious, I'm not talking about your awareness. You might not get the infection because of your carelessness, but someone else's carelessness. If you're going to tell me that someone else's carelessness is because of the lack, ignorance of awareness, I really might differ. See, we are all talking about awareness in what mode? In TV, television, or in what mode? Are you telling me that Indian population is in a way that everybody's got TV to see? And is Indian population, everybody's got three meals to eat? We are so heterogeneous. We are so pathetic about economic stability that few people do not even have 10 rupee biscuit packets to eat a meal. And you have to be reaching to every nook and corner, every person, because this virus is contagious very clearly. That we all know. So talking about getting infected and going to a hospital, you have to go meet the doctor. Are you telling me the doctor is not aware enough? Doctor has to have this personal protection equipment. I had a friend in Savita, COVID duty doctor. He called me up and he told, I am scared for my life because I have not been provided a proper personal protection equipment. And what does that fall under? Awareness or infrastructure? Now the government has to provide the infrastructure that doctors need first thing, and then they can focus on this. Obviously, the base thing is awareness. I'm not saying we'll have to bypass awareness to create more infrastructure for the doctors and the hospitals. But what is more important real time practically is when you are helpless, you go to the doctor. When the doctor is helpless, what does he say? Kadavulukuda. So obviously, the chain of events where you can make a difference is not at the point of awareness, and it is at the point of infrastructure. Talking about, events where they talk about Kerala. Can I give you an example how you all know how densely Maharashtra and Bombay is populated? So are you going to tell me that awareness is going to, what awareness can do to a person who is living in a 10 by 10 room with 15, 20 people in Bombay? What awareness can you give? What awareness can you think will help him? You think he has to go out or wear masks inside the people? It is not going to help. So obviously these people are going to get infected. They will go to the hospital, and when the hospital is not going to get them admitted, how does it help? That is my point. So very clearly, doctors' infrastructure is very important. Talking about economic stability and data and facts is very, very important. Indian government spends 4% of GDP for taking care of the infrastructure, and they give an economic relief package at 20%. Are you serious? Are you telling me that you cannot 4%? If they had at least 10% of GDP every year taking care of this infrastructure, you think by now 4% on health infrastructure developing and 20% for the impact that the infrastructure is not able to create on the economic stability? As well, see, it is very simple that I do not want to talk about Japan because Japan is so resilient. We cannot be compared to the population of Japan. I really worry with that point. Japan's people particularly can never be compared to Indians. Never. And now talk about China, that's another different story. People are very hardworking, not like in Indians. And sir, anyways, I'm not going to let Madhu Priya to accompany you because she is aware, first place. The second place is she knows that the infrastructure in the Roypuram or Roypeta government hospital is pathetic. So I'm not going to let her, and I highly recommend that you do not go there also. So because although you might be very aware, we're not supposed to be taking any daredevil stance to walk into a COVID zone. As well, to conclude, I would say that Team B is only of words and no action. What I am saying as Team A representative, I'm saying actions is what it matters right now. Gone are the days where with the words, the Kerala spread
actually contained. Nothing happening right now. Just put it into action, make more infrastructure, give the doctors what is necessary. They will actually try to get it down, and thereby we will all stay safe at home. First being aware, second being aware of the infrastructure that the government has for us. Thank you for the opportunity. Back to the moderator.
Thank you, Hemant. Actually, I'm amazed, pleased and floored by all the debaters' speeches. And almost everybody have done a lot of research on this particular subject and gave a detailed speech. But because of their detailed speeches, we got a little bit delayed. So audience, please, just 1 minute for two people. If you have something to contribute, your own thoughts and opinions on the arguments that is presented, please, you can raise your hand. Just two people, just 1 minute.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. May you know your name?
One is Fazal here.
Pardon? Sorry, I couldn't hear you.
Hello, sir. My name is Fazal here.
Yeah, please go ahead.
So, very thankful for all the Toastmasters who have contributed fantastic information and sharing the brainstorming session. And I request not to go personal to anybody, because it's not a challenging session. It is the awareness, and it's the brains who are going to decide and contribute and suggest to develop our own system, personal system, the family system, the organizational system, and the system of the society. We are here for our common good, and I request everybody to not to get it personal, because it becomes very harsh for the people to digest or to reflect back. And we, with due respect, we have to respect each and every person. And I really enjoyed everybody's opinion, which is more valuable than anybody else. And it's very professional and very educational. Thank you for the opportunity, and very grateful and with gratification. Thank you.
Thank you, Vasilur.
Yeah.
Anybody else would like to contribute?
Yeah, it's Ramesh.
Yeah, Ramesh, please go ahead.
One of my friend's mom and dad, her mom want a surgery. For that, the doctor asked to test the corona. His mom and dad went for the hospital for the testing. When they came back after that, she felt something wrong, and the test has been confirmed it is negative. Till that point, she don't have anything, both their mom and dad, but now they both are conducted as corona negative, and they have been isolated now because of visited hospital.
Corona positive, okay.
Yeah. So what is the issue and where we are lagging it? This is my point. We are telling that hospital has been very clean and good, but when they have visited there, my friend told me it was very waste why they have visited there. Because of that itself, it affected them. And even now, he is afraid, because that also affected of him as well. He will also get affected. This is my point.
Thank you, Toastmaster, for adding your personal story, real story. So to conclude, because we are running out of time, I would like to conclude this way. In order to sink a ship, a small hole is enough. Just one hole is enough, not necessarily two holes. So even if we leave one hole left, just like that, the ship will sink. So in order to build a strong country, we have to improve both medical infrastructure and also improve public awareness on health. That is what I personally feel, and that is what the lesson I learned from COVID-19. So with this, I leave this stage to Toastmaster. Toastmaster, please.
Thank you, moderator and debaters. This was a very good debate. All speakers, they put forth their constructive points. Really, we enjoyed the debate. And thanks for visiting us to provide such a wonderful debate. Thank you once again. Let me move on to the last part of this one, this meeting, general evaluation. I would like to call upon Toastmaster Balasundar to provide the general evaluation.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anand Raj. We'll move on to the evaluation session. To start the evaluation session, I'd like to invite Toastmaster